بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and upon his family, his companions, and upon all those who follow upon his guidance, to proceed, إخوان, فنواصل معكم شرحا على عقيدة الواسطية للإمام العلامة شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى من الشرح للعلامة محمد بن صالح العثيمين رحمه الله تعالى. So we continue benefiting from, studying and rehearsing from, memorizing from the words or the explanation of the book or the metin of the book Aqidat al-Wasitiyya that has been composed and authored by the great Imam, the Allama Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, from the explanation of the noble Imam, the Allama Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen.
في ذريته واللي قبل نوح ما يكون من ذريته. إذا من القرآن ثلاثة أدلة تدل على إيش؟ على أن نوحا أول الرسل.
So he says, so there are three proofs from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which indicate and point to the fact that Prophet Nuh was the first messenger sent to mankind.
ومن السنة ما ثبت في حديث الشفاعة أن أهل الموقف يقولون لنوح أنت أول رسول أرسله الله إلى أهل الأرض.
And he says, as for the sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, then there's an authentic hadith that the people of Al-Mawqif, they said to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, O Nuh, verily you are the first messenger that Allah Ta'ala has sent to the people of the earth. Translator's note, this hadith is collected by Al-Imam Al-Bukhari and Al-Imam Muslim.
أنت أول رسول أرسله الله إلى أهل الأرض وهذا صريح.
So then the Sheikh, he says once again, رحمه الله العثيمين, he said the last part again, that the people said, O Nuh, verily you are the first messenger that Allah has sent to the people of the earth. And he said, this is صريح, this is crystal clear.
إن آدم عليه الصلاة والسلام فهو نبي وليس برسول.
He says, as for Prophet Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام, then he is a prophet. And he is a Nabi, and he is not a Rasul. He is a Nabi, he is a Prophet of Allah, and he is not a messenger.
إدريس ذهب كثير من المؤرخين أو أكثر المؤرخين وبعض المفسرين أيضا إلى أنه قبل نوح.
He says, as for Prophet Idris عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said there are many of the historians, the scholars of history. He said, or I would say most of them, or I would say some of them. He said, they had the opinion that Prophet Idris, alayhi salatu wasalam, that in fact he came before Nuh. That he came before Nuh. He says, and that he is from his ancestors, meaning that Prophet Idris came before Nuh. He said, many of the scholars of history, they have this opinion. He said, but this opinion here is extremely weak.
والقرآن والسنة ترده.
He says, and the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, it argues that, it refutes that. It's in opposition of that opinion.
بالصواب ما ذكرنا.
And that which is correct is that which we have mentioned. رحمه الله تعالى. رحمه الله تعالى.
آخرهم محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And he says, as for the latter of the prophets and messengers, as for the latter of them, then the last of them is Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Alayhi salatu wasalam.
لقوله تعالى ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين.
And the proof to this, that the Messenger Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is the last in this seal of all the prophets and messengers, is the statement of Allah, translator's note, that comes in Surah Al-Ahzab. That comes in Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. As Allah Ta'ala, He says about His Messenger Muhammad, but rather He is the Messenger of Allah and the seal of the Prophets.
وَلَمْ يَقُلْ وَخَاتَمَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ.
He says, and Allah Ta'ala did not say, and He is the seal of the messengers. He said He is the seal of the prophets.
لماذا؟ لأنه إذا ختم النبوة ختم الرسالة من باب أولى.
He says, why is this, you may ask? Why did Allah Ta'ala say He was the seal of the prophets and not the seal of the messengers? He says, because if He's the seal of the prophets, then He's the seal of the messengers. There's no need to say that. He's the seal of the prophets. If He's the seal of the prophets, then it is more deserving that He is the seal of the messengers.
ومن ثم نعرف خطأ بعض الناس الذين يقولون محمد خاتم الرسل.
He says, so from this we understand that the mistake that some people make in their speech when they say that Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام خاتم الرسل, that He is the seal of the messengers.
كده نقول الأفضل أن تقول خاتم النبيين.
He said it's better for them to say, it's better to say what? That He is خاتم النبيين, that He is the seal of the prophets.
وإن كان قد يصح خاتم الرسل باعتبار أن الرسل والنبي.
He says although it is correct to say that, but it's better if they say the seal of the prophets.
أنه خاتم للجميع.
He says, because He is the seal of the prophets and the messengers. But it's better to say He is the seal of the prophets.
وعلى كل حال فآخر الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So he says, at any rate, the seal and the last of the prophets and messengers is Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام.
فإن قلت عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام ينزل في آخر الزمان.
He says, so if someone says to you that Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام, he is going to descend towards the latter part of the time, towards the ending of the time.
وهو رسول.
And he is a messenger.
فما الجواب؟
So if this is the case, if Muhammad is the seal of the prophets and Isa is going to return towards the end of the time, and he's also a messenger, how can you explain that?
نقول نعم هو لا ينزل بشريعة جديدة وإنما يحكم بشريعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He said, we would say to the likes of that yes, your statement is correct, that he is going to descend towards the ending of the time, but he's not going to descend with the new legislation. He is not going to descend upon the people with a new legislation, but rather he's going to rule by the legislation of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He's going to rule by the legislation of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam.
طيب إذا قال قائل من المتفق عليه أن خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيه أبو بكر.
He says, so if someone was to say to you that it is agreed upon, it is unanimous, it is agreed upon that the best of this ummah, translators note, ummah meaning those that come after Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, if someone was to say to you that it is agreed upon that the best of this ummah after its prophet, meaning Muhammad, is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. So the best of this nation, this ummah after the prophet, is agreed upon, is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq.
وأنت تقول الآن إن عيسى يحكم برسالة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أو بشريعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And now you're saying, O Sheikh, now that Isa is going to descend upon the people, and when he does, he's going to judge by the legislation of Muhammad.
فيكون من أتباعه.
So therefore, he's considered to be from his followers.
فكيف يصح قولنا إن خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيها أبو بكر؟
So therefore, if Isa is going to come towards the ending of the time, and he's going to judge from the legislation of Muhammad, then he must be from his followers. So how is our statement correct that from the best or after the best or the best of this nation after his prophet is Abu Bakr? How can this be correct? So one of the students began to say something and is not as clear. His words is kind of muffled. And you hear the sheikh said, what do you have to say, oh, Abdul Rahman?
نقول هذا من غير الرسول يعني معروف أن الرسول خير من الصحابي بلا شك. قال المؤلف رحمه الله والبعث بعث.
He says so here is he is not from, he's not talking about the messengers, not talking about the messengers of Allah.
هذا الموت البعث بمعنى الإخراج يعني إخراج الناس من قبورهم بعد موتهم هذا من معتقد أهل السنة والجماعة.
Then he continues and he says, and then Ibn Taymiyyah mentions, continuing in the recitation of Al-Wasitiyya, وَالْبَعْثِ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ, and in the resurrection after the death, after the death. He says, this means the ikhraj, when the people make, when they come forth, when the people come forth after, from their graves, after their death.
البعث بعد الموت هو إخراج الناس من قبورهم أحياء.
So he says, when the people once again, what does it mean that after بعد البعث بعد الموت, the resurrection after the death? He says, this is the إخراج. When the people come forth and they're going to be alive, they come forth from their graves after their death.
إخراج الناس من قبورهم أحياء.
He says once again, saying again, that the people are going to come forth from their graves, أحياءً, and they're going to be alive.
بالكتاب والسنة وإجماع المسلمين.
And this affair is established in the Book of Allah and in the Sunnah of His Messenger and with the consensus of the Muslims.
إجماع اليهود والنصارى.
He says, and with the consensus of the Jews and also the Christians. They also believe in this.
حتى اليهود والنصارى يقرون بأن هناك بعثاً يبعث الناس يوما يبعث الناس فيه.
He says even the Jews and the Christians, my brothers, they also have this belief that mankind is going to come forth after their death.
ويجازون.
And they're going to be recompensed and rewarded.
وفي القرآن يقول الله عز وجل زعم الذين كفروا أن يبعثوا قل بلى وربي لتبعثون.
He says as for the statement of Allah Ta'ala that supports this is the statement that Allah Ta'ala mentions, translator's note, as it comes in Surah Al-Taghabun. The Shaykh recites the ayah where Allah Ta'ala says, زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَلَّا يُبْعَثُوا قُلْ بَلَى وَرَبِّ لَتُبْعَثُونَ. Where he says, that Allah Ta'ala says in Surah Al-Taghabun, that those who disbelieve, they claim that there's no resurrection. Those that disbelieve, they claim that the people will not be resurrected. قُلْ بَلَى وَرَبِّ لَتُبْعَثُونَ. Say to them, O Muhammad, rather, yea, by your Lord, or by my Lord, they are going to be resurrected. Or you are going to be resurrected.
وَقَالَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبْعَثُونَ.
He says, another occurrence, translator's note, this comes in Surah Al-Mu'minun. As the Shaykh recited the ayah, where Allah Ta'ala says, ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ لَمَيِّتُونَ ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تُبَعَثُونَ. Where Allah Ta'ala says, and then after that, they are going to be resurrected. And then on the day of resurrection, you are going to be resurrected.
وَأَمَّا فِي السُنَّةِ فَثَبَتَتِ الْأَحَدِيثُ مُتَوَاتِرَةً عَنِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ فِي ذَلِكَ وَأَجْمَعَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ عَلَى هَذَا إِجْمَاعًا قَطْعِيًّا.
A correction, ya ikhwan, in our translation regarding the ayat in Surah Al-Mu'minun. As I said, ba'da dhalika lamayyitun, after that, they are going to be resurrected. The correct is, after that, they are going to be dead. Thumma innakum yawm al-qiyamati tub'athun. And then after that, on the resurrection, that their recompense, their resurrection, you are going to be resurrected. So the Imam Al-Uthaymeen, he continues. He says, Rahimahullah, as for the Sunnah, then there are many, many ahadith, and the number has reached the mutawatira. There are many, many, many numbers, or much, the number of the hadith is great and numerous regarding those ahadith that show that the people are going to be resurrected. And the Muslims are unanimous in this regard.
وأن الناس سيبعثون يوم القيامة ويلاقون ربهم ويجازون بأعمالهم.
And the Muslims are unanimous that the people are going to be resurrected يوم القيامة, on the day of resurrection, and they're going to stand in front of their Lord. They're going to meet their Lord. They're going to stand in front of their Lord, and they're going to be recompensed and rewarded based upon their actions.
فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره.
As Allah Ta'ala says, translator's note, this comes in Surah 2, Zalzala, where Allah Ta'ala says, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Allah Ta'ala says, and whomsoever does an action equal to a mustard seed of good, then he is going to see it. And whoever does an action equal to a mustard seed of evil, verily he is going to see it.
يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقي.
And Allah Ta'ala also says, O mankind, إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقي. He says, O mankind, and this is translator's note in Surah 2 Al-Inshiqaq. Allah Ta'ala, he says, O mankind, verily you are going to meet your Lord. You are going to return back to your Lord. قَدَحًا فَمُلَاقِي. Of returning فَمُلَاقِي. And thus you shall meet him.
فَتَذَكَّرْ هَذَا اللِّقَاءِ حَتَّى تَعْمَلَ لَهُ.
He says, so ponder and reflect over this meeting that's going to take place, that indeed you're going to meet your Lord. If you ponder and reflect over it, you're going to behave in a manner that shows it. You're going to work in accordance to it, having fear. You're going to have fear of the standing in which you stand before your Lord, the mighty and the majestic, on the day of resurrection. And you're going to have fear that when you stand before your Lord on the day of standing and recompense, that you don't have any good deeds. That you don't have any good deeds that are accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ.
So he recited the ayat again. Verily you are going to return back to your Lord, of returning, and thus you're going to meet him.
انظر ماذا عملت ليوم النقلة وماذا عملت ليوم اللقاء.
So he says, so look and consider, what have you put forth for this day, the day of this meeting between yourself and between your Lord.
فإن أكثر الناس اليوم ينظرون ماذا عملوا للدنيا.
He says, for indeed most of the people of today, they only consider what have they put forth with regards to this dunya. What have they put forth for this dunya?
مع العلم بأن هذه الدنيا التي عملوا لها لا يدرون هل يدركونها أم لا.
He says, and they have knowledge, they know, the people that do this, they know that the affairs of this dunya, that which they have worked for this dunya, and that which they put forth from this dunya, they know that perhaps they will receive it, and perhaps they may not receive it. They know that.
قد يخطر الإنسان لعمل دنيوي يفعله غدا أو بعد غد.
Where a person may devise a plan or a scheme in order to do such and such tomorrow from the affairs of this worldly life.
إنه لا يدرك لا غدا ولا بعد غد.
But in reality, although he planned this thing out to carry out this and to do this and to reach this tomorrow, he never reaches it. Not tomorrow, nor the day after tomorrow.
لكن العمل لكن الشيء المتيقن أكثر الناس في غفلة من هذا.
He says, but the thing that is certain, that is inevitable, that is going to take place, most of the people of today are heedless of it and could care less about it.
قال الله تعالى بل قلوبهم في غمرة من هذا.
He says, Allahu Akbar. As Allah Ta'ala says, translate his note in Surah Al-Mu'minun. He says, Allah Ta'ala, he says, بَلْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فِي غَمْرَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. He says, Allah Ta'ala says, but rather their hearts are in a state of heedlessness with regards to this. Surah Al-Mu'minun.
وَأَعْمَالُ الدُّنْيَا يقول وَلَهُمْ أَعْمَالٌ مِّنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ.
He says, and when it comes to the actions of the dunya, Allah Ta'ala says about this in the same surah, Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah Ta'ala says, وَلَهُمْ أَعْمَالٌ مِّنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ. Allah Ta'ala says, and they have actions and works besides this, and they are striving, trying to acquire it. Surah Al-Mu'minun.
أعمال الآخرة قلوبهم في غمرة.
He says, when it comes to the hereafter, their hearts are in a state of heedlessness, in a state of neglect.
منغمرة, غافلة. لكن أعمال الدنيا ولهم أعمال من دون ذلك هم لها. شيء قدم المعمول ليفيد الحصر.
He says, but when it comes to the affairs of the dunya, Allah Ta'ala says, but they have actions, they are striving, trying to acquire it. And he says in the grammar, Allah Ta'ala put the ma'mood to show emphasis.
هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ.
As Allah Ta'ala says, هُمْ لَهَا عَامِلُونَ. And they are for this working, trying to achieve it.
وَقَالَ تَعَالَى لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. يعني يوم القيامة.
And Allah Ta'ala says about the hereafter, and indeed you, translator's note, this comes in Surah Al-Qaf. لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. Allah Ta'ala says, and indeed you are in a state of heedlessness when it comes to this.
فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ.
Allah Ta'ala says also, فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. Allah Ta'ala says in the same surah, talking about يوم القيامة, on the day of recompense, Allah Ta'ala says, and then we're going to remove it from you, غِطَاءَكَ, your covering, and your eyes on that day are going to be as if they were steel, حَدِيد.
هذا البعث الذي اتفقت عليه الأديان السماوية وكل متدين بدين هو أحد أركان الإيمان الستة.
So with regards to the resurrection that all of the divine religions, all of the divine religions are in agreement to, and that everyone believes in from those divine religions, he says, and this is from the six articles or six pillars of belief.
وهو من معتقدات أهل السنة والجماعة.
And it is from the belief, from the beliefs of the people of the Sunnah and Jama'ah. The people of the Sunnah and the people who are being together.
ولا ينكر أحد من ينتسب إلى ملة أبدا.
And there's no individual who truly ascribes himself to أهل السنة والجماعة who denies and rejects this. And denies and opposes this.
وقوله الإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره.
He says, and then Ibn Taymiyyah goes on to mention, rahimahullah, والإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره. He says, and having belief in the qadr, it's good and it's evil.
هذا أيضا الركن السادس. الإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره.
He says, this is the sixth pillar, or the sixth pillar from the pillars of belief, that the person believes in the qadr of Allah and the divine decree of Allah, it's good and it's evil. He says, when it comes to the qadr is the taqdeer of Allah, the decree that Allah has decreed for the ashya, for the things, for the affairs.
Yeah. وَقَدْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ مَقَادِيرَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَخْلُقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ.
He says, and indeed Allah, the Mighty and the Majestic, He has written the decree of everything that was going to take place before He created the heavens and the earth by 50,000 years. By 50,000 years.
كما قال الله تعالى ألم تعلم أن الله يعلم ما في السماء والأرض.
He says,
إن ذلك في كتاب إن ذلك على الله يسير.
As Allah Ta'ala says in the ayah, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي كِتَابٍ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٍ. As this comes in translator's note, Surah Al-Hajj. Allah Ta'ala, He says, Sheikh Uthaymeen mentions that Allah Ta'ala, He says, do you not know that Allah, He is the one that has knowledge of everything that's in the heavens and everything upon the earth? إِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي كِتَابٍ. Indeed, this is written in a book. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٍ. And indeed, this is something that is extremely easy upon Allah. Surah Al-Hajj.
وَقَوْلُ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ أَمَّا وَصْفُ الْقَدَرِ بِالْخَيْرِ فَالْأَمْرُ فِيهِ ظَاهِرٌ.
He says, so Ibn Taymiyyah continues, that you believe in the Qadr, it's good and it's bad or it's evil. He says, as for the Qadr being described with khair, with goodness, he says, in this affair, this is apparent. This is ظاهر. This is apparent.
وأما وصف القدر بالشر فالمراد به شر المقدور.
He says, as for the description of the Qadr being